Boa tarde. Mario, eu queria ser obrigado pela organização desta de hoje. É uma honra de ser aqui. Estava uma importante de ser aqui hoje. Agora eu vou falar em inglês. Okay, then thank you, João, for this introduction. I think it was some slides. I will be very quick because we have almost the same. I will today present quickly where are we and the future. It will be a little science-centric, what is our roadmap from we call PIMS to NIMS. I will explain these things. I discussed several times with Gaspar. Gaspar, we were in this role of delegate in the council, and you will see several images of Gaspar during my talk. This, I will be quick because it was presented in a very well manner by Juan about this number of centers. I'm taking only the center of proton therapy and carbon, and you can see what was already described in Europe, in US, and also mainly in Japan, and you can see the big increase we will get in the following years. Also the same thing, I think I want to compare, we have exactly the, more or less the same thing, but to say that we can see increase of treatment by proton therapy, this from 11 to 17, I didn't get the number from 18, an increase about 80% of the number of treatment by proton therapy, but more for carbon therapy, 120%, and more important thing is for children. I think it's very well in line, and I'm very convinced they will increase in the future. I will not show, but I think we have the same, but just to keep these two slides to see what was the difference between 2002 and 2015, and you can see in Europe a lot of increase of the things, and I agree now we'll be soon too in Madrid, but I agree these white things, and I will come back later also in this region where we have not the two regions in Europe where we will need for the population some hadron therapy, proton or carbon. Okay, coming back to this study, what we call PIMS, Proton Ion Medical Machine Studies. It was hosted by CERN in the 95-96 with the support of MedAstro Oncology 2000 and Terra Foundation to start to have a design of a synchrotron for proton and carbon therapy for treating cancer. The idea is to have a toolkit, and after that, to develop the toolkit on different implementation. And the two implementation was, first of all, CNAO in Pavia in Italy, and after that, MedAstro, starting with design from CNAO and with other design made with cooperation with CERN, MedAstro in Neue Weichstadt, close to Vienna. Then these two centers are now in operation, was mentioned by Juan, proton and also carbon, what is, I think, two-thirds now in carbon in CNAO, and MedAstro is starting with proton, it will pass to carbon later. Okay, now looking at what we can do for that, what can be the next step. Proton therapy is progressing a lot, and I think now more and more is a turnkey facility. We have a lot of industry possibility, variant, IBA in Europe and in Japan. I think for us, looking what we can do, we said we will not interfere with the proton therapy. I think it's establishing and so on. The question about accelerator, cyclotron is well established and so on. What we can do is more about ion therapy, carbon, but maybe lighter ions, helium, and so on. And I think for that, we will need two things. First of all, to collect more data for biomedical research, to look at the RBE effectiveness of a radioresistant tumor and so on, that definitely we will need some center with not only treatment of a patient, which is important, but also research to work on that. And The idea was to look at what can we do. The first idea of PIMS with the synchrotron was in 95. Now we are in almost 2020. Do we have new development in accelerators that we can go further? And we come to that. And also, in very important, is a delivery system, including the gantry, but it's very heavy, large, and you have to move around the patient. Some people are dreaming to move the patient, but it is another thing for the patient and also for the moving of the organ. Okay. Then now we launch at CERN this study, but it is a NIMS, Next Ion Medical Machine Studies. 20 years later, the PIMS, and after the LHC construction, but also new ideas about LINAC, superconducting LINAC. And then I think it's a time to look at what can we do. And the thing it was to look at a new generation of a medical accelerator for dedicated to carbon, more compact, cost effective, and as I said, dedicated to carbon, and maybe to investigate some light ions. To come back to that, and because I had a lot of questions about CERN, CERN is, it should be very clear, CERN is a commission, is basic research, fundamental research. We are not doing medical application. It's not our mandate. CERN is doing transfer technology towards medical application. And we had in June 2017 approval by the CERN Council about the role of CERN, and it was clear that we don't want, and CERN should not be in competition with Heidelberg, with Knaum, with Ostrom, with all the things. What we are doing is transferring technology towards these things, and so our role, for example, for PIMS and NIMS is really to produce, transfer this technology developed in terms of toolkit for implementation. And now for that, we have a new organization at CERN where we are internally CERN Medical Application Steering Committee. I'm the chair, and we have two bodies to help us from the one CERN Medical Application Advisory Committee, which is mainly the doctors or the specialists. And I want to have this slide for that. The CERN Member State Knowledge Transfer Thematic Forum is really to have the opinion and to share with all the member states and associate members of CERN the where are we, where we have to do to work. And I'm showing that because we start the dedicated forum for medical application in 2017, and Gaspar was the representative from Portugal at these things. Unfortunately, due to illness, he was not very present, but he was every time was sending email to me, giving his position and pushing in the direction to for the training and for starting this proton therapy in Portugal. Okay, this was a list of the topics where we want to go to collaborate, but from CERN. First of all, Médicis. I will give a word of Médicis. Médicis is a facility just behind Isole Nuclear Physics to use the proton beams from Isole to irradiate some targets and to work for innovative radioisotopes for medical research. Once again, it's not to provide isotopes for diagnostic therapy and so on. It's to give to the community of the collaboration different type of radioisotope, and the hospital, the institute are doing their own research to look at if it has some future. And for example, there is this interesting terbium 155, and if this one is really a good thing for radiotherapy, I think after that we will have to find a center to produce this terbium. I want to show you all these 14 institutes collaborating in Médicis, and you can see that Technico Lisboa is one of these institutes. Secondly, I think CERN with the LHC, we develop a lot about superconductivity and high field magnets. Then I think we were looking, can we transfer this know-how about superconducting magnets towards hadron therapy and also towards gantry. And it was at the time we were approved by the CERN Council this strategy for medical application to start this collaborative design study of a new generation of compact and cost-effective light ion medical accelerator. For that, we organized in June 2018 a dedicated workshop to call all the experts from around the world to think what is the requirement of the next type of machine and what is the direction we have to do. Gaspar was invited. Up to the last moment, he was to come. Unfortunately, due to problem of illness, he didn't come. But he sent once again some support for that. The outcome is really that we know from the medical part what is the requirement. We know the energy. We know all. No big change. But the main thing is to decrease the cost. To avoid this Southampton effect, really now more or less an proton therapy standard cyclotron is 30 to 40 million. The other one, don't want to compare IET now Medostron, but we are speaking of roughly 120 million of euro. Can we decrease by a factor two or factor three this price? To have higher beam intensity spot, to reduce the footprint of the things and to install that in an existing hospital to profit of that, and obviously to have the operation, to reduce the operation cost. But also what is very important now, I can see the painting of the tumor. We paint and modify the frequency, that is say, the penetration of the proton and the carbon beam in the tumor, and using multiple ions. I think this is very important. And once again, the gantry now that are huge, and in terms of weight to move, and in terms of cost, could we do something? Then after the workshop, it was clear that we have two options for the next generation of the carbon ions accelerators. The two last part, the LINAC up to 10 MeV is definitely a LINAC, and all the beam delivery in country will come back. But the two are either a superconducting synchrotron or a LINAC, high frequency LINAC. And now what we are doing in collaborative way is to look at up to mid of next year to compare and to analyze these two solutions and based on the result to choose one and to produce, as we produce for PIMS a toolkit, to produce a toolkit, expecting after that to have a facility where we can apply and we can go to the technical design based on that. Just to show that this is a superconducting synchrotron based on a CCT magnet, you can see the difference with a footprint that will be 27, more or less, a little less than 30 meters of circumference. If I compare with now a Medostron, what it is a range of 80 meters. And you can see in terms of footprint, it could be one third. And when you reduce the footprint, you reduce all the installation, all the things, and maybe you can install easily close to an existing hospital. Also, other things is a linear accelerator, and we are thinking about the folded things, and you can be very things very compact in these things, more or less less than 50 meters long and folded and so on, and you can have several delivery. And this is definitely also a good thing, and this is very nice to do painting of other things. And for gantry, to look at superconducting gantry, definitely we have to go to superconducting gantry if you want to reduce the size and the weight. And there is now two options we have to analyze. Is a rotational CCT magnets launched by the Terra Foundation, and a toroidal that we are at CERN with Luca Bottura. This was, I think, a very important innovation, what you call GAT toroid, a novel superconducting compact gantry. We had a very nice seminar last year, and you can see here the different size for a proton, because the energy is different between a proton beam and a carbon beam. Estimate mass 12 tons, it seems heavy, but it's an order of magnitude what it is existing today. A normal gantry for proton is close to 120, 150 tons. And for carbon estimation is 50 to 60 tons, is once again an order of magnitude lower what it is existing. And you can imagine we have not to move the things. So after that, we will have to move. You will move the beam feeding the different coils and so on. And now we have to be to work to do a kind of prototype and so on. But I think this is a very encouraging idea. In terms of collaboration, I mentioned at the beginning it was Spain and Portugal where we have to install more things, but it was also in the southeast of Europe something, and now you know there is an initiative to build a hadron therapy center in this Balkanic country, and for this project called Southeast Europe International Institute for Sustainable Technology. And now supporting by EU, and we are working together to have EU design studies in the last call of Horizon 2020, and to do that. Then this is design study is in preparation with CERN, but also GSI, CEA, you saw INFENC, now Medostron, IT, and so on and so on, and to work together on these kind of things. And this is good synergy to look at a standard system, which could be with proton, but also with carbon, and the new way to do that. Okay, on this development of this new ions therapy, we have also some contact with India, Latvia, Iran, and Sweden, and maybe we can, I think, discussing with Gaspar, also with Portugal. I think the main thing will be training of young people to attract young people to train them, and after that, to define according to the what we want to do, the different countries, the different time schedule, these people can work on the technical design report for the things and to work for the installation of the things. And now, as I said, also we are now collaborating for this pivoting country, and we have we signed now a new collaboration with CNAO, INFN, and Medostron to develop, to look at how to develop quickly this Gatoroid country. Okay, this is what I want to say on this new way of carbon and light ions in complement of what it is existing on proton therapy with industry. But I don't resist to say also that we spoke about maybe we can improve something in Europe, but when you are looking the world, you can see that there is nothing in Africa. And now, maybe before to think to proton therapy, hadron therapy, it was a project really pushed by STFC in UK, but also by the International Cancer Expert Corps. They went at CERN to discuss if we could do something on the normal radiotherapy, but to develop in a challenging environment something that we very low maintenance, very low cost, and you can spread out in these different countries. Then we organize a series of workshops to prepare that. You can see in 16, 17, 18. Last one was 19 this year in Botswana with more than 60 participants. And this is definitely some perspective in the low and medium income country to do that and to how to develop this kind of very compact, very resistant, with almost no maintenance radiotherapy system. And once again, I think this education training, I think, is very important. And I think discussing with Gaspar about the thing we can discuss in the discussion, I think this train young people in this domain is very important. And now they are discussing the priority. Initially it was 5 projects, but to go to 1 or 2 and to develop this project. I want to finish and to say muito obrigado to Gaspar and muito obrigado for you.